Liam, you're smiling already. How's the week been after that victory in the derby?
As good as it could have been, really. I think from all the celebrations that you've seen at the end of the game on Saturday, I think that carried over a little bit. And we enjoyed it as much as we could have. So I think it's about putting that to bed now and focusing on finishing as strong as we can in the league. And that starts with tomorrow.
You joined the club, I think, aged 8?
Yeah.
What's it like after, 15 years then, associated with Swansea City to score a goal in the derby against Cardiff?
I think it's a dream come true, really. I started coming to watch this team from, I can't remember how old I was, but I remember the game. It was against York City at the Vetch. And I've always talked about, since I was a kid and started playing football, that I wanted to play in these games and I wanted to score against them. So it's one of my lifelong dreams that's been ticked off. So hopefully there's a few more of them to come.
Yeah, how old would you have been then, when you first went to the Vetch? Trekking up from Pembrokeshire, I guess.
Yeah, I think I was around 4 or 5. It was obviously in League Two. I wasn't old enough in 2003 when we managed to stay in the league. But I think it was around 2004, maybe.
Who was up front? I'm trying to think. Who would have been up? Was Trundle at the time?
Trundle was
then,
here by then, yeah. Trundle was here by then. Paul O'Connor was up front. I got a few players in the back of my mind that was there.
You must have faced Cardiff quite a few times through the age grades, I guess, and scored a few, no doubt.
Yeah, I think the first game I played ever against Cardiff was here, and I think I scored 2 in that game. But, yeah, I've had a bit of a habit of scoring them in the youth ages, so it was nice to finally get one at this level, which is the main thing. So, yeah, like I said, hopefully there's a few more of them to come.
And once again, your goal, you just always seem to be in the right place. Whenever the ball comes loose in the penalty area, you always seem to be the one there to put it in.
Yeah, well, I think that's one of the main parts of my job. Obviously, you have a big part to play in build-up and while we're trying to make our way up the pitch and the job we have off the ball. But I think the main job as a striker and the main aim is for every striker is to score goals. So I just try to make sure that I'm in the right position every time the ball does get into the box and I'm the one that's alive to anything that bounces or any crosses that come in. So obviously it was nice to see another one fall to me and hopefully I can get a couple more of them.
How do you know where to go?
I think I just work off instinct, to be honest. Just try and get myself in the best position possible and in the middle of the goal, but yeah, we'll see what happens.
And then, I mean, going back to last Saturday, sorry, Cabba scores 84 minutes. It looked like perhaps victory had gone away from you. Tell us about the feeling when Ben Cabango scored that late goal.
I never really thought that someone else's goal would be the best moment I've had in football. I was sitting there, me and H were sitting there, Harry Darling, and I just said to him, imagine we score here. And when the ball fell to Ben, of all people, I couldn't get off my seat quick enough. And I think you've seen from the celebrations how we all reacted. But yeah, it's definitely the best feeling, running over to that away end, seeing all the fans the way they were. It was amazing to be a part of.
It's just looking across the season as a whole, it's been a real breakthrough year for you, hasn't it?
Yeah, I obviously had a bit of a stop-start season at the start with my shoulder and the injury. But I think I really took that time when I'd done that injury to knuckle down. I'd done a lot of work with the physios, the medical team and Rhys as well. And then once I got that chance where I come in and scored against Coventry, it was just, that was the main aim really, was to sort of try and cement my place as much as I could. And just try and prove what I can do at this level. So I'd like to think I've done that to a certain extent. I definitely think I've still got more to come. I think the focus now is to just keep building, try and have as strong a finish to the season as I can. And try and keep going.
And you've also been called up by Wales. Tell us about that and how did that feel?
Yeah, I was just at home on the Monday night, just sat down, had some food and was about to watch some TV before I went to bed. And I had a call off Mark saying that I was getting the call up into the squad. So it was a little bit of a rush around on the Monday night to try and get to Cardiff. And I didn't get there till late. But yeah, the experience was unbelievable. It only makes me want more. So I think it's about trying to impress as much as I can in these last 8 games or however many it is. and just try and prove to them that I'm good enough to be involved in that setup and that squad and contribute to that team as well.
Yeah, Coventry City to come tomorrow. Six more games, I think, after that. What's the aim for you and the team for the rest of the season now? Because you're in the middle of the table, you know, people might think you haven't got a great deal to play for.
I think it's just about proving how good we are and how high we could be in this table. Obviously, we had that sticky patch, which didn't help us at all. But yeah, I think we still have a point to prove in terms of how good we are, in terms of the way we do things, that we can really hurt teams in games. And on a personal level, yeah, it's just about finishing as strong as I can and seeing how well I can play in these games. And yeah.
Get to double figures would be a nice first target, I guess.
Yeah, I think so. I think I've got 7 in the league, 1 in the cup. So our big aim would be to try and get to double figures. Hopefully get to that double figures in all competitions first and then look at getting it in just league games. But yeah, as long as the team are winning, it makes no odds to me who scores the goals and gets us the 3 points. As long as the team are doing well and we are proving ourselves to be a really good team in this league, I'm happy.
Thanks, Liam.
Cheers.
Morning, Liam. Good to see you. Just going back to last week, in terms of watching your goal back, we saw the celebration, how much it meant to you, but how many times have you watched your goal back?
A few times. I've watched Ben's more than mine.
I was just going to, that was my next question. Yeah. Is it that one off?
So I think I've watched Ben's a few times where I just go and look at the reaction of all the boys and just watching every one of them, how much it means to them. I don't think you couldn't pick out one player where you think it doesn't mean as much to him as it does the other. So I've definitely watched that goal a lot more than I have my own.
And the manager said straight after the game that he was pleased to see, you know, yourself, Joel, Ben celebrate with authenticity, was the word he used. You weren't afraid to show that this means the world to me and go in front of the fans, the home fans, and show that this is a massively proud moment for you individually.
Yeah, 100%. And I think when you have a moment like that and it means that much to you, I don't really think you care who's around, who's watching you, who's saying whatever they are to you. The main thing for me is I've scored for my boyhood club in a derby against that team. And it is a lifelong dream of mine. So, yeah, I'm going to celebrate the way I did, show how much this club means to me and how much it means to me scoring in that game. And then at the end, me and all the boys are going to celebrate the way we did because of how much it means to us. I definitely wouldn't have it any other way, and I'd do exactly the same again if it happened this week.
And we asked you about Joel Pirro last time we spoke to you a few months ago. You know, you've blossomed as a partnership. You were in the right place from another one of his from off the post, same at Coventry, I think it was, and Reading as well, I think it was as well. Just how great is it to play with somebody like him, because you know, you really seem to complement each other, don't you?
Yeah, it's massive. I think every time I step onto the pitch with him, I know what he's going to give us. I think he knows what I'm going to give him. Like I said before, he makes it so easy to play with him, especially with his performance on Saturday. I thought he was the best player on the pitch, to be honest. The way he controlled their defenders and the way he was with the ball and off the ball as well. So, and you could see with his goal how much quality he brings. Hopefully we can keep going the way we are, keep adding to our numbers, keep helping the team, and hopefully they turn into more 3 points.
And Gaz asked you about the Wales situation, getting to train. It must be a great feeling to be involved, but obviously the next step is to get into a matchday squad, get minutes and get caps. Is that something you've spoken about with Rob Page, maybe for the summer, and is that a real target of yours now?
Yeah, it's definitely a target of mine. It always has been, really, to be in that Wales setup. I've come all the way through the ages from 15s and 16s to 21s. And I've always had that target in mind. But all this, the three coaching staff, the gaffer, Nilly and Eric all pulled me and just said how happy they were with me at the end of the week. So I think that was a massive boost for me, knowing that I'd done myself no harm. It just makes me want to keep getting the call up and keep impressing in the Championship for Swansea. And hopefully that call up will come.
And in terms of your own situation here, Liam, I think you've got 1 year on your contract after this, but there may well be an option for another year. Is that something that you've looked at, and maybe hopefully you can get a bit more long-term security, because you've certainly impressed this season and hopefully you can keep building on now and become a real mainstay in this team?
Yeah, it's not something I think about too much, really. I don't think it's something for me to comment on or or to talk about, really. The main focus for me is just to play football and play well for this club. It's always been the biggest dream of mine to play for this club, and now I'm here, I just want to do as well as I can and help this club as much as I can, because obviously everyone knows every time I step on the pitch, I'm going to give everything for this team. So yeah, the situation is what it is. If anything is talked about, then we'll see what happens, but it's not really something that's at the forefront of my mind.
Thank you very much, Lee.
Cheers, thanks.